The demolition of a dam along the 12-mile river in Pickens County should begin today.
It is one of the final stages of cleaning up a pollution problem that dates back decades. The News 4's Sean Mazzarello is live and local now from the 12-mile river in Pickens County. And Sean, so tell us, why do they have to tear this thing down?
Well, the hope is that once they take this dam down, it'll wash away some of the contaminants that environmentalists say are there because of an old textile plant. This was built along the 12-mile river, and the 12-mile river actually feeds into Lake Hartwell as well. So what they said is that there was PCBs. These toxins were dumped into the river, and now they want to wash them out. The actual dam that's being taken down is around this corner. We couldn't get our live truck there because it's a tricky shot, but we did shoot some video, and we want to show you that now. You can see the heavy machinery is in place. This 30-foot dam is concrete. They're going to start ripping it apart around 8 o'clock this morning. This is a court-ordered removal, by the way. A court settlement from 2006 determined that the former St. Gamo Weston capacitator plant dumped the contaminants in the water from 1955 to 1977. So the idea behind removing the dam is to allow the clean sediment to flow downstream and cover the contaminated lake bottom. Now, let's get a better look at what they're actually going to be removing. These are the actual two dams that they're going to remove. Woodside 1 dam is coming down starting today. The Woodside 2 dam is going to start coming down this summer. Both are on the stretch of the 12-mile river dotted with signs warning of the PCB contaminants. The company responsible has already paid more than $65 million as part of this Superfund cleanup. These dam removals are going to be about $22 million as well. So if everything goes as expected, which I think it should, this will start being removed around 8 o'clock this morning. I'm Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4 Today, live and local in Pickens County.